This is the free kick section of the 2011 Aloha Clinic tapes. And free kicks can be confusing because there's people all over the place and it encompasses the entire field. 90% of the calls can be made either right in front of the runner, blocks in the backs or holds, or on an onside kick. And you have to be prepared at all times for either one. Let's get started. Play number one is just a simple encroachment by the kicking team, and I put it in here because this does not look severe. In fact, I can't see anybody over the line. Philosophy is on an onside kick, you're very strict. That's considered a hard plane for both the kicking and receiving teams. But if it's just a normal kickoff like this, you can give a little bit of leeway. Sure, if their body's over or you've got a full foot down, go ahead and call it. But on a situation like this, let the game flow. Here's another philosophy play. This is a long kick kicked out of the end zone, and on the same play we've got illegal block in the back called on the return team. This is generally something that we will shy away from unless it's a personal foul, and then we want that called.
Block in the back on the return team. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Play number three, this is what I was talking about. Right in front of the runner. Illegal block in the back. In front of the runner. Now the mechanics in five-man are a little cumbersome for picking this up, so referees, you're going to have to get this first attack. You're not going to get much help from the sideline because they're located a little further upfield. But you can see where I had it highlighted for the referee. That's a block in the back. That's point of attack, and that is a priority position on the field we have to make sure gets covered. Here we go again, play number four. Priority position right in front of the runner. The first threat against the runner. See where the referee is? He's going to have the best view of this, but it's crowded, so maybe we can get some help from the sidelines. But you can see that guy comes in. He's the only blocker who's coming in on those four people who are trying to make a tackle, and he springs the block with an illegal block in the back. So that is a play we have to pick up. I've gone back and forth on this play, but this is a good call for a hold, and it's right in the middle of the run, so I think a little easier to pick up than that first threat. But right in the middle of the run, I'll highlight the guy with an arrow right here. He grabs him. You can see the defender still in a pretty good pursuit position. Grabs him, buckles his legs a little bit. So that's a good call for a hold, even though it's not one that you would normally see. It's kind of unusual. It's from the back. It looks like he's trying to pull his pants down. But good job by the crew for picking this up.
During the return, holding on Y&I, 10-yard penalty from the spot, first down.
Play number six, this is an offensive hold that's called on player number seven. It's a little bit further into the return, so it's a good job for the deep guys to be watching in front of the runner. Here's the guy we've got highlighted. It doesn't look like much to start with, but he's got him, and then he ultimately takes him down. It may have been after the runner went by him a little bit, but a takedown is a priority call, so this is a good call for holding. You can see number seven coming across. He's got him, restricts him, plows him to the ground, so that's a good job for the holding call.
During the return, holding on the receiving team, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, singles.
Play number seven, there is an offensive hold at the first threat position. You guys know what I'm talking about when I say first threat. It's the first guy in right here. Referee, you've got the best look at this because the runner is not threatened, and you can see that the blocker just tackles the guy. There was a flag thrown on the play for illegal helmet contact. I couldn't see it. It may have been that hold. It may have been something else. But this is definitely a hold. First threat right there. Grab, tackle. So that's a priority call for the referee, and maybe the wing guys can help too. Play number 8 and play number 9, these are just maybe kicks out of bounds. I put these in here because they're really tight. They're good discussion plays. This first one, the kick comes down, and it may or may not have hit that player. And then number 3 grabs it while he's airborne, maybe in, maybe out. That's for you guys to discuss, but it's a wonderful play. Referee, need to back up a little bit on that. Gives yourself some space. Play number 9, This one's more interesting because it's airborne all the way. You got to look at left foot versus right foot. Are we going to call this a kick out of bounds, or are we just going to call this the receiver touched it? He did give a fair catch signal, but again, officials, back up. Give yourself some room to make those calls and to look at the play. Play number 10, this is just an observation play, also a mechanics play. Look at the player I've got highlighted at the top of the screen. He gets blocked out of bounds and returns. That's legal. The receiving team muffs it. Official here I've got highlighted, fight the urge to come upfield. You're right in there. You are too close to the action. So, going back to this play, what we're looking for, kicking team was blocked out. They're legally able to come back in. If he wasn't blocked out, that's a penalty when he comes back in, but this has got a lot of stuff going on, including the mechanics, so it's a good discussion play. Play number 11, this is a kick to a goal line, and this is just one of those situations that are hard to officiate because the player's back is to the referee doesn't know if the ball is over the plane of the goal line or not. The reason I put this play in here is because it's a give them what they want play. If you can't see the ball and you're not sure if it breaks the plane of the goal line or not, if he comes off the goal line in a run, let him run. If he hands you the ball, it's a touchback. The third category on a free kick, which is one of the big things we have to get, is the pile picker play. Pile pickers happen on free kicks, I think, more than any other play because it's so spread out. So I've highlighted this guy. The runner's going down. He's out of the play. Bam. Blows a guy up on the perimeter. Referee, you can see him coming up too close. You stay back, you pick that action up. I've got a couple more pile pickers here because it's so critical in the free kicking game to be able to pick this up. Well, actually, any part of the game, but it happens a lot in the free kicking game. This one's against the receivers, so you got to watch both teams. Watch the top of the screen, number 20, goes from right to left and blows a guy up. Okay, stay on your perimeter. We've got to pick these up. Next pile picker, this is going to be on the kicking team. This seems to be a little bit more common. But, again, stay on your perimeter. Keep your field of vision wide open. And here's a guy that comes in real late. He actually hits the guy a little bit lower than that. That's a personal foul. That guy's got nothing to do with anything, and he knows that the play is over. Last of the pile pickers, at least on the free kick, this is against the receiving team. So you can see there's a little bit of a scramble for the ball. Somebody's looking for something to do when this play is over. The only thing you can think of to do is to cream a guy on the sideline. I'll stop it here so you can see who it is. Okay, play's over. Runner's down. That was a good pickup. The crew did pick up that hit. Completely illegal. Don't go with block in the back. That's a personal foul.
Dead ball. Personal foul. On the return. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Well, that's actually...
You want to talk about a play. This is an onside kick that never hits the ground, although you wouldn't know it, but from this angle. And the kicking team catches the ball. It's beyond 10 yards. Everybody's saying, yeah, kicking team's going to get it. This is a big playoff game. And the crew came together, and they discussed it. Now, they had whether or not the ball hit the ground, which it didn't, off of the tee. They had the fair catch signal by the receiving team. They had the ungrounded catch by the kicking team. And ultimately, when they got together and they discussed all this, they got it right. It was kick-catch interference against the kicking team, and they got the awarded fair catch. Play number 17, again, an onside kick. And this was marked as a first touch by the kicking team. This one did come off of the ground, and mechanically we have to figure out who's going to get that. But you can see the umpire drops his beanbag right there in the center of the zero on the 5-0. And he ruled that touch right there. Now, whether he's blocked into it or not, I think you can lay off of that blocked into there. But he does bag it short of the 50, so it did not go the proper 10 yards. That was a great pickup by this crew. This is a free kick. Unusual timing for an onside kick, which is why we can't get ourselves stuck into a rut. We've got to be ready for an onside kick on every kickoff. Inadvertent whistle. He anticipated the recovery. You can see by his mechanics he's all messed up. And when that happens, the crew gets messed up. So nobody runs in here quickly enough to start separating the pile. We need to be prepared mentally for an onside kick on every kick. Remember at the opening we said the two things in the free kicking game is first threat and onside kicks. Those are the two major things that are going to happen on a free kick. The rest of the 10% we can figure out how to pick up. So he thought the guy was going to recover it. He didn't. It's still loose. Blew the whistle. Fess up to it. Be honorable. Inform the coaches what happened. And replay the down. Play 19. This is the last play on the free kick. It's an onside kick. And I wrote almost perfect because I want you guys to discuss something on this play. Looks great, right? Looks great. Awarded him a first down. I want you to watch a single player and his interaction with one of the receivers, and I'm going to highlight him here, and there's a bunch of different angles. He uses his right arm, and he spins that receiver, number 53. So to me, it looks like a hold or illegal use of hands, or whatever you want to call it. But you guys discuss this. We'll let the rest of these angles run through, and you can decide whether this was a perfect onside kick or a perfect hold. That's it for this one, guys. Hope you enjoyed it.